Many of us, alhamdulillah, still have the blessing of parents. And may Allah Azza wa Jal preserve our parents and guide our parents, overlook their mistakes and protect them. But imagine if one of you has a mother who's extremely sick. And, you know, the father has passed away. And she's the only one left. And she's very, very old. She can barely get out of bed herself. She's that old, she can't even speak properly. That old woman. Now, there was a time when you and I were helpless, now she's helpless. She's in completely a helpless state. And then she somehow communicates to you, can I borrow 100? I promise I'll pay it back soon. I'm not sure when I can do it, but I will, I promise. And when she says that to you, what would that make you feel? That would make you feel, and me feel, you're my mother. Why didn't I know that you needed something, that it came to the point where you had to ask? And even the way in which you asked tells me what you think of me. You think of me as someone who would not just give you out of my heart, but after I give you, in my heart I'd be thinking, when am I going to get this back? Is she going to pay me back or what? My mother is thinking I'm so greedy. My mother thinks I'm so obsessed with money that her, what she needs and what she wants is not even in the picture. My biggest concern will be, when am I going to get paid? When am I going to get return? Humiliating to a son or a daughter to hear. Why? Because now they're getting an impression, what does mom think of me? Mom thinks of me as someone greedy. Mom thinks of me as someone that would, he wouldn't just give it to me. The best I can hope for is he'll let me borrow it. And then he'll expect it back. That's a commentary on your mother and how greedy she thinks you are. That's what that becomes. When Allah Azza wa Jal tells a believer, give me a loan. The one who gave you and me everything says, give me a loan. He knows how human beings become. I'll give you a small experiment that I've conducted many times with my children, especially when they're younger. I know which ones like which kind of ice cream. So I'll get their favorite kind of ice cream and start eating it myself. And so I'm eating it, eating it, eating it, and the three-year-old comes and says, Abba, can I have that? I said, no, you can't have that. Can please have a little bit? Okay, you can have 2 bites, but then give it back. So I give them the ice cream. And guess what happens next? They run away. And if I do catch them and say, where's my ice cream? You know what they say? Mine! Immediately, they forgot that this wasn't theirs. This was mine. I just let you hold it for a couple of seconds, and all of a sudden, now it's yours? And before I can get to it, the biggest bites they can ever take in their life, because they just want to get as much as they can. Human beings, when they get possession of something, even temporarily, we tend to forget that it's not ours. Allah gives, and Allah gives, and Allah gives. And then sometimes He says, give me back. Spend. And what's the first thought that crosses in my mind and your mind? It's mine. You want me to give from my money? You want me to give you from my savings? I worked hard for these savings. You want me to give up this? This is my favorite one. You want me to give up this car? I can't do that. That you're asking too much. And so Allah Azza wa Jal acknowledges the inherent greed. وَمَن يُوقَ شُحَّ نَفْسِهِ Allah says, whoever can be protected from the deep greed they have inside themselves are the ones that have reached success. So Allah calls on that greed and says, you and I would love to hold on to our things. So Allah says, you know what? You really, even if you give it, you're thinking, when am I going to get it back? So Allah says, why don't you give it to me? Let me borrow it. And it's not going to hurt you much. That's Allah's guarantee, because it's just a qard. It's just a slice from what you have. And that's confirming the promise of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, مَا نَقَصَ مَعْلُمْ مِنْ صَدَقَةٍ When you give charity, your wealth doesn't go down. When you give up something for Allah, your money does not go down.